Hi guys, what's up? Alright, so today I'm going to talk about certifications while you prepare for your CAT. Now I'm going to make two videos. In this video, I'm going to talk about a couple of certifications predominantly. Unko karna chahiye, nahi karna chahiye, you know, while you prepare for your CAT. And the next video, I'm going to talk about what are the certifications that you should be doing while you prepare for your CAT. Now, if you're new to my channel, let me introduce myself. My name is Ketan, the IIM Ahmedabad alum and also a founder of CAT to CET Mentors. Let's start with this video and let me help you. Alright, so can we talk about a lot of certifications like CFA, FRM, project management, you know, then Six Sigma, you know, actuary and all that stuff, right? So whether you should be doing it or not. Now, I'm going to take you guys step by step. See, the point here is that more than CAT, CET, ZAT, NMAT and all that exam, what we are more keen on is MBA Finance, MBA Marketing, MBA HR, MBA Ops. That is because that's a long-term thing. That's what you're going to do throughout your life. And that's the reason we're like quite keen on that. And that's where students kind of opt for, or rather I get a lot of queries ki, sir, main CAT ke liye prepare kar raha hu, mujhe mera gap nahi dikhana hai, mujhe mera gap fill up karna hai, to kya main CFA karu, main FRM karu, kya main PMP karu, which is a project management program, you know, kya main koi PG program kar lu, ya fir main XYZ courses kar lu, and all that stuff. So I get these questions all the time. And the answer is no, big no. You are not supposed to venture yourself into CFA, FRM, PRM, CPA, CIMA, PMP, all that stuff. Absolutely not. Now I'm going to give you a rational also. Why do I say that? Number one, let's understand from a student's perspective. See, if you're a repeater of CAT or maybe you're writing CAT for the first time, right? The point is, these are all aptitude kind of a stuff. So you have different level of study, different fundamentals are there. On the other side, CFA, FRM, this is a theoretical kind of a thing. So, dono jagah ki jo preparation ki jo level hai, jo preparation ka style hai, wo alag-alag hai. That's number one. Number two, we are not more keen towards aptitude preparation, quants, DILR and all that. What we love more is theory, understanding new stuff, understanding market, understanding strategies and all that. That's where zyada attention lag jata hai. And that's the problem, because if you're doing these two things side by side, which are South and North Pole, then there is going to be a clash, a big clash. Now, I don't advise you to take these heavy kind of, you know, professional qualifications, because trust me, they are heavy. Even if you're a commerce guy, CFA level 1, thoda heavy jata hai because uske calculations hote hai, derivative ke calculations hote hai, BA wali jo calci hai, wo use karna hota hai, FRM to bahut zyada quantitative hota hai, even PRS for that matter, CPA, CIMA, ye sab programs yaar accounting oriented hai. So problems ho jati hai. That's the reason I do not advise. Now, pehli reason to maine aapko bataya, because dono ke fundamental, dono ki style jo hai, wo bahut alag hai. Iske liye hota kya hai ki aap uske sath cope nahi kar pate ho. Dusri cheez, isme kya hota hai, you kind of lose your focus quickly on your CAT. Because as I said, right, for the fact you are interesting, rather fact you are enjoying your CFA, FRM, it's a theory, you are learning something new, and you know that, you know, finance is going to be my bread and butter. Operations is going to be my bread and butter. CAT to matlab, it's just kind of a, you know, a gateway to the B school. But what I'm going to do my life for the next 40 years is finance or operations or marketing. That's for sure. And that is the reason yahan pe interest zyada badhne lagta hai. Aur eventually kaise hota hai? Now, as and when you move ahead with your months, like, you know, June, July, August, you go down on your CAT because you're not scoring well, you're not getting scored marks, so you get demotivated. But then, you know, kind of, you know, you are kind of more keen towards CFA and all that. Now, eventually what happens, even if you crack CFA level 1, but guys, trust me, cracking CFA level 1 and scoring 80% in CAT is not going to help you. Instead, not doing CFA, FRM or any other program which is heavy, which will consume a lot of time, it's better to stay focused on one thing in your life, which is CAT, CET, CMAT, ZAT, whatever. Give your 100% to it and then get a good score. Because the moment you are getting into top 10 or top 15, top 20, all these certifications will not matter. So there is a very good chance that you will divert your mind, and because of which you will go away from your CAT. Because of the all these things that I have just mentioned. Second thing, why it's too early to decide CFA, FRM and all that? Because the moment you get into B school, now you don't know what B school you're going to get. That's for sure. So if you get into top B school, you don't need all these things. Again, I'll be making a video like, you know, a kind of a good time to do these kind of certifications. So yeah, if you're getting into any kind of a B school, you don't know ki karna kya hai. Finance aapko pata hai, but finance bahut vast hota hai. So top 10 milega, top 15 milega, top 20 milega, no idea. Now what happens is, the moment you get into your BSulka interview, they see that, oh, you know what, you've got CFA level 1, you've got FRM. So they build a perception that you are a CFA guy, means you are more keen on equity. You are an FRM guy, means you are more keen on risk management. You are a Six Sigma guy, matlab you are sure that you want to get into operations and all that. So interviewers will have a perception about you. And that's the reason it's all good, rather it's kind of good, not to have these kind of qualifications on your resume. If you have it, if you have already done it, and now you only want to focus on CAT, level 1 pehle ho chuka hai CFA ka, abhi sirf CAT katna hai, if I am a student, I'll sort it out for you, that's my promise. But agar nahi hai, they don't venture into CFA. Toh ye problem hote. Dusri problem ye hoti yaar, for the fact you don't know what you should be doing, actually, aapko equity research karna hai, aapko mergers and acquisitions karna hai, aapko derivative mein chalna hai, aapko wealth management mein chalna hai. For the fact we have no idea about the profiles, having that qualification on your resume before you do your specialization is not a good idea. But let's say you are a BCom guy, MBA finance for sure, or you're an engineer and you want to do MBA finance for sure. But that's what you need to be sure. But you're not supposed to be sure on CFA, because not every profile in finance will ask for CFA, FRN, and so on and so forth. So let's say if you venture into MBA and you get interested into risk management, derivatives, then CFA is not suitable. What's suitable is FRN. And that is the reason, if I look at, you know, the way that, I mean, you don't have a year's time. May, June, July, August, September, October, 6 months in your hand. Aapka CFA ka attempt hoga December mein ya fir June mein. But again, aapke jo exam chalne wali hai, wo Jan mein bhi hogi, Feb mein bhi hogi, March mein bhi hogi, November, December mein. November ke baad pura season on ho jata hai. So my advice is not to venture into all these things, all these certifications as of now, because today we don't know. We just want to be MBA finance, but in finance, what vertical and all that, we don't know. So try not to divert your energy. Try not to divert your attention, your focus. Don't do that. Just focus on CAT. Try to get in a good score. Try to get into top B school. You will not need CFA and FRM if you're from top B school. Trust me. Why? I'll explain that later on. But as of now, if you're doing CAT ka preparation, or if you're preparing for like ZAT or CET, whatever, trust me, do not venture into any kind of a thing. Do courses which are light enough, which can help you to have a certification on your resume, which will not consume much time, which will not take 1 hour, 2 hours, like more than that in a day. CFA will take more than that, trust me. So managing classes, managing coaching, you know, managing studies, mocks, everything, everything's gonna get jumbled up, so don't do that. Then that's the reason I say, it's not a good idea to take all these heavy things just to fill your gap. You might get succeed in filling your gap, but then if you do not score well in CAT and CET, you might have to compromise on a low level B school. Now, low level B school, CFA is not a good deal. Top B school, no CFA, no FRM, can be a good deal. So guys, that's all from my side. If you have any doubt, any concern, any issues, you wanna have a discussion on this about your profile, my details are mentioned below, you can connect to me. I'll be more than happy to help you. Stay tuned to my channel and stay tuned to CAT to CET Mentors. Thank you so much.